Hello again. Quick update on a couple. Oh, she's run off now. Quick update on a couple. Firstly, I found my tripod, so the camera work should be a bit better. Monk's had a malt, my Brachy Brodesi. You can see her here. She's got my torch. You can have a good look at her. She looks so much better now than she did before, which I'm very pleased about. In here, somewhere, she's just gone and hidden. Ozic, she usually sort of comes out throughout the day. And she's actually been sort of making herself quite happy around there, which is quite good. But today, I have a couple of slings to open. I've decided I wanted to grow something from very small. Seems like an old hat that these looking after transfer things now. So I bought a couple of slings. I've got a Greenbottle Blue and a Brachy Smithi, which the Smithi I really, really wanted because to me, being a movie fan, it was sort of the ultimate movie spider. It's the one you always saw in the films. So I've got a couple of slings. So let's get them open. Now, I have them both. B Smithi and the GBB. Now what I bought was, just to briefly explain, some food containers. They're probably a bit big, I'm thinking, for the size that the slings are, but I mean, I don't think it should matter too much, being new to looking at slings and whatnot. The only thing I'm waiting for now is the sub, which I ordered yesterday, which should, hopefully should be here today. I can put a good layer of that in, and then, like I say, there should be an enclosure, which is, like I say, probably a bit too big for them, but you should do them for the first few months of their lives, maybe a year or so. Like I say, I am annoyed at myself for buying the sub from online. I should have got it from somewhere else, but the place I usually get the sub from, they didn't have particularly good stuff. The last video I put up, I've still got some of the sand that was in there, but that sand is terrible. I know slings need to be kept more moist, but I just don't trust that stuff, so I'm waiting for some soil to arrive. But I just wanted to show you the containers. eBay, I got 10 of them, I think it was, for about £2.50 delivered. Very small, very compact, drilled some not particularly good holes in there, but it's enough to aerate. And then also what I'm probably going to need to do at some point in time is get some labels so I know who's who and where's where. The Greenbottle Blue I'm going to be calling Harvest, after the Blue Harvest, and that's not the Family Guy edition, that's the original version of what the Blue Harvest was. And the B Smithi I'm just calling Bill, after Bill Smith, who's done a lot of work on some of the Star Wars books. Bill and Harvest, that's what they're going to be called. Right, as soon as I got my sub, I shall be getting them out. Sorry about that. Okay, sub is in. I compacted it down. The stuff that I buy is good and moist. So it should be enough for them. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the camera down here. Right, now then, I think we're going to go with the green blue bottle first, because it's the one closest to hand. I'm anticipating they're probably going to be quite skittish, and also make a run for it. In fact, probably people are saying you should be doing this in the bath, because they're going to make a run for it, which is actually a really good point. Let's try in the cardboard box. Maybe I'm being overly paranoid. The last thing I want is a tiny little tea running around this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that in there. Now then, hopefully, I don't know what you're going to do. Oh, see there. How does that look? If I do it on the end there, shall I? Sorry about it, it's not very professional. Like I say, missing my camera pencil. There we go. That's a bit better. I'll get a close up in a minute. Toolage. as with last time with the spider shop, they've wrapped it up very well, but I'm also not too scared about getting my hands too close to them, even though it's probably going to run right up my arm. Oh, it's tiny! I think I've got an enclosure far too big for this thing, because it is absolutely tiny. Hello, little fella. You want to come out? Yeah, no, don't attack the prongs. There we go. He's very, very cute, though. He or she. There we go. Go on down. There we go. There we go. He is tiny. As a sling. Let's get the... There he is. I'll get some photos in a minute, but firstly, you're not getting out. There we go, stay there where we are. But yeah, he's quite a good colour. I'll get some photos, try and put them up, but I'm quite pleased with him. He's going to grow up to be quite a little stunner, I think. Okay, right, let's get him away with the lid. That enclosure is far too big. I think I might have to get a couple of smaller ones. There's plenty of air holes for him though. He's so small. Right, let's try the Smithi. Okay, again, exactly the same procedure. This one's got a screw top lid on it. Hopefully we're getting that shot again. Let me just double check. There we go. Sorry about the funny angle and whatnot. Toolage. This is the tea that I have wanted originally. The B Smithi. Like I say to me, it's a classic looking tea. He's slightly larger. I did buy a slightly larger one than the smaller one that they do. So he's slightly bigger. The enclosure might just be the right size for him. Hey mate, shall we get a paint brush, because that's going to be a bit softer, isn't it? Go on, there you go. Now don't run up the side. He's cute. Not showing much of the colours just yet for a B Smithi, which is what I'm going to be waiting for when he's harder. But he's quite nice. You can see some of the yellow on there. On his legs. He looks good, he looks like a good size. Like I say, it's slightly larger, and they have a smaller one, but I went with a slightly larger one. And there we go. Two slings unpacked. I'm going to put his lid on. He didn't get away. He is slightly skittish. I was thinking about, oh, see, he nearly gone out there. He was making a run for it, but he didn't quite do it. And there we go. Two slings unpacked. Oh, there's Aussie. There she is. Like I say, she'll come out throughout the day and wander around. But if I get too close or make any sudden movements, she always darts back in under a little hide. But she's looking quite good after her molt, which is nice. There we go. All done. That was easy. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll obviously keep up to date with what's going on with them. I'll take some photos and maybe sort of put them on the end. But quite pleased with those two. That's quite good. Again, thanks for watching.